Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome back to another build challenge. So for today's build challenge, I decided to do one that was holiday themed, because quite frankly, I did not do a lot of holiday stuff this December. So with that said, we actually have a build challenge that is partially inspired by The Nightmare Before Christmas, which is of course celebrating its 30th anniversary, and unfortunately I haven't built anything from the movie. So on that note, we are in the world of Forgotten Hollow, and that of course is the home of vampires. Unfortunately, there is one very scary thing in this world, and it is this build from EA, which I'm sure many of you guys know, it has quite a bad reputation in the Sims 4 community. And with that being said, I'm going to attempt to turn this home into a holiday home. But of course, I will be only using base game, vampires, and possibly the holiday celebration pack. Now, as a quick note, I don't really have any other build restrictions, but I will do my best to keep the general integrity of the house intact. So hopefully this can turn into something really beautiful and not so scary, and hopefully fit for the winter season as well. All right, so on closer inspection, this house is very square. It doesn't really have a lot going on in the whole backyard situation. So that does give us a lot of room to expand the house if we wanted to. But of course, going on inside, it is very mismatched. It's very modern and contemporary for some reason. Going up, we do have only one bedroom and some very interesting choices in the bathroom. So those are definitely going to go. Now, I did notice that there is sort of this childlike bookcase here, so I'm thinking we can add possibly a children's room to this house, but I think for the rest of the rooms, I think they are fine. We're just going to move things around and definitely give this house a full-on makeover. All right, from the get-go, we're getting rid of these trees. They are very dead, and they are not helping with the holiday vibes. Wow, okay, there is a lot. I would think this house is abandoned with all of these brambles everywhere. We also have cracks, so we're gonna fix a lot of the walls and foundations. We definitely don't want this to be dilapidated. Okay, so I'm not gonna lie, you guys, the cracks are actually very hard to see. They blend in very well into the wall. I think I can spy them if I zoom in close enough. I feel like I'm going to miss some, so if you guys see any, let me know. Okay, I think we're good on the outside. I don't see any more cracks, so the house is fully repaired. It is not remodeled, but it is repaired. The inside, though, is a little bit shabby. Let's get rid of some of the water stains and cobwebs. Upstairs, we have some mysterious holes. I don't know where those came from. More stains around the bed. Yikes, okay. A lot of them for some reason. I don't really know what was happening here, but we're gonna let the past stay in the past. All right, so if I'm being honest with you guys, I think the windows are a bit much. They're very repetitive with so many close together. So let me delete them for now. I do think we could approach this with a colonial style, because if you're thinking, you know, Home Alone, cozy suburban America, I guess, that could be a warmer direction for this house, because right now it is super, super dingy. I do like the brick, so let me see if we have some better options. I could do maybe something like this. We do have a little bit of a white trim, so this could brighten up the house a bit. Honestly, not feeling this door. I think I will just go ahead and remove it. There is a possibility that we could center the doorway. That could maybe help some of the build. Ooh, could we do maybe a walled-in moment right here? If it cooperates, just like this. Not really keen on this foundation either. It's very dark. We could go for maybe another brick like this. Do we have anything that matches? I don't think so. I don't think we have anything that matches this brick. All right, definitely need some railings. We do not need people falling down. And we can actually use the one from the Vampires pack. Ooh, I would love to do some columns. Could we do some columns on the sides of the entrance, perhaps? We do actually have some nice ones from the Vampires pack, so I could do something like this. Yeah, I think this option is a little bit less distressed, I would say, so let's use this for now. We could even do a little pseudo balcony moment up there, so I could pull this once more and just create a little bit of a landing area like this. The roof is looking a little bit tall, so I think I'll select it and I'll actually turn it around like this, and it can possibly give us some room for dormers. They're a little bit grand. They're a little bit grand for my taste. I wonder if we can do something different with them instead. All right, guys, so dormers, I don't think they're going to happen. They need to be very, very tall if they are going to fit with the build, so unfortunately, I don't think I can do them. The roof, though, we can change because it is, again, a bit dark. All right, I think I'll do this for now. It's kind of a slate blue, which I think is fine. And then maybe a white trim like this, just to lighten things up a little bit. All right, so I think I will have to remove these windows for now. I kind of feel like they could work, but I do have to figure out where they're going to go. and I may test some different options as well. We definitely need to replace the door, and unfortunately it's just base game and vampires, and vampires does not have any outdoor options. Oh, there's one, there is this, which actually is not too bad. I think we could probably just do two of these from base game and kind of reflect them just like this. For the windows, I do want to include the vampires pack options. Because I don't want to lose the spirit of the house entirely, if that makes sense. So maybe I could use something like this, maybe in an all white. I feel like we might have too many windows again, which I'm not really sure what to do about. I could extend the house out a little bit because we do need room for another bedroom up here. Perhaps we can do some kind of garage moment, which I'm not really sure how that's going to work. But I have seen a lot of extensions like this coming off of colonial houses. Could we possibly have a nice bay window moment? Perhaps. We could use something over here, maybe something like this. Maybe two is too much, but I think I might go for it. It's not looking too bad. The problem is it doesn't really match with the vampires pack content, which it's troubling. It's definitely troubling. But we could still do something a little bit smaller, maybe something like this. I don't actually mind if this piece is symmetrical at this point, because I do think we need to balance this out if we are doing a colonial style. So let's do this. We're going to bring these on over here. And I think this is a better look for the house. Awesome. I don't know how well these flowers are going to hold up in the wintertime, but this is The Sims, so I'm going to pray that they're going to be fine. So here we go. These could be poinsettias, perhaps. Maybe something like this could do. How do I feel about the brick? Now I'm second guessing it because those flowers are so red, and the brick is just a little bit on the orange side. Ooh, this could be a really good option. So let me try it like so. All right, I do think this is looking good. I think I will go back to maybe the lattice for the foundation itself. We definitely need to move over this house. So let's see, maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or maybe 4. I actually think it would be cool to have some kind of parking area over here. So it's not going to be a garage per se, but it will have some kind of overhang. So let me try that out. I don't actually mind this gravelly area here. I might change it just a little bit. So I'll keep the gravel, but go for a lighter option. All right, carport area. Let's do this. We're going to use the square brush to make this a little bit easier. And I'm just going to pat it in like so, right next to the house. Debug cars, here we come. And Vampire's Pack definitely does not have any, but I'm okay with that. I will do a base game car instead. So maybe I'll use this. I'll use a little red convertible here. It's looking a little weird, I'm not going to lie, you guys. Could I just kind of bop this down like this and still make a roof? All right, here we go. Will it work? I don't think it will work, you guys. No, it doesn't work. No! There goes the plan. There goes the plan, you guys. All right, guys, sad news. I cannot find this trellis. I know it's in base game. It is this wooden structure with kind of a roof over top, and it does have some flowers on it as well, but it's just not here. I really don't know where it is. So unfortunately, we cannot do the little carport area, but I will use some fencing from the Vampires pack. So hopefully it will at least make this lot look a little bit more elegant. So I'm thinking we could do a taller fence piece like this. Unfortunately, we cannot go all the way up to the edge, but I could start it here and then wrap it around the property. I can even create a little bit of a curved path going to the parking area itself. All right, let's get in some lovely hedges so the fences are not completely bare. Do I overuse hedges on fences? Perhaps. Perhaps I do, but you know what? I think it looks great. I think it adds to the curb appeal, especially because this lot originally had very, very scary landscaping. So I think this should be an upgrade. All right, for the mailboxes. I know mailboxes are very slim pickings, but I think we can find something somewhat decent. Probably this option. This is actually not too bad. I don't think Vampires has any of this content, but I think base game should be fine enough. Probably should put even more hedges around the car. I think it's kind of barren not having some kind of fence, so let me do that. I could actually still do a trellis moment if I wanted to. I could actually put it maybe just one tile away from the house. Probably borrow from these just to keep it cohesive. All right, let me delete the walls now, and we should still have the roof intact if I wanted to do the lattice on top. Let me actually get a smaller fence piece. I'm going to use the Vampires pack option once more and then just close it in like this. Can't really see it too well with the hedges, but I might fix that a little bit. And then going up top, we don't have any more roof. Snap. Okay. I did not think that through. So here we go again. Let me fix this. All right, just like that. And we do have the trellis portion, which looks good. Okay, I think that is looking better. I don't really mind a little bit of foliage there, so I think that's fine. We do need some trees, though, so that is going to be a little bit interesting. If we do want to match the world, there are some around, but if I'm thinking holiday, I usually think of maybe pine trees or evergreen trees. Ooh, we also have these, which actually work quite nicely. I can scale them down a little bit, maybe just about there, perhaps, just like this. Ooh, you know what? This magnolia tree is not bad. We also have this option as well, which does have little white flowers. All right, I'm gonna do some vampires pack debug because I do think there are some good trees in here, so as long as they're not dead. So let's see what we have. Ooh, better yet, these actually look a lot better. So these somewhat match the green we have up front. So let me do, where is it? Aha, here you are. Let's do this instead, scale down just like this. All right, I do enjoy that. It's a little bit mysterious. It's kind of weeping willow-like, but this is still, of course, in the world of Forgotten Hollow. So, you know, the little creepy horror aspect, I'm okay with that. Also going in now and just going to add a little bit of dirt around some areas just to add a little bit of realism. And normally I go for my favorite pineal texture, which I do believe is this one. Furious clicking here, you guys. It's so much. I'm dragging and clicking just to pat it in, but I do think it's looking a little bit better now. All right, we can add a few flower bushes in the front. I think that will help out the landscaping just a little bit. Could we do these hydrangea flowers, I believe they're called? Maybe in white, they kind of remind me of snowballs, which is kind of fun. Unfortunately, you guys, it has been a very long time since I've actually seen snow, let alone play in it. When I was a kid, I loved playing in the snow. I did snowmen, snow angels. I didn't really do sledding, but we did have this plastic saucer you could actually ride, and it was a lot of fun going down any kind of snowy street or snowy mountain. It was a blast, honestly. Driving in that snow, however, probably not the funnest for my parents, but thankfully we don't have to deal with that anymore. All right, I think I went overboard. Let me move some of these in and then possibly introduce some other plants as well. I think I will go for the other round hedges that I do like. So maybe something like this, just to kind of border it up a little bit. I do think smaller could actually work even better, so they're not too obnoxious. Lastly, we do need to see what this looks like at night because I'm sure it's very, very dark. But we can put some nice, probably wall lamps over here. And I think that should do the trick. Don't think the Vampire's Pack has anything good other than candles, so let me stay away from those for now. But something nice and classic would be great here. Probably something like this, perhaps. I could do it in a black like this. Maybe some more over here as well, just to brighten up this side. And I think we're roughly at maybe this height. Probably some over here as well, just to brighten up the carport area. Am I matching the heights? Not really. So let me fix that. That is honestly a very hard thing to keep track of, is managing the lamp heights, which is very difficult sometimes. Could we do some nice old-fashioned street lamps? Maybe. All right, so let's do this. We're gonna do base game and of course vampires. We actually have this lovely street lamp here, which is actually not too bad. And it also has some red flowers, which could be the poinsettias. So let's do this, probably put one on each side. Oh, we're missing one up here, which I don't know where it went, but there we go. There is the lot now. Overall, I'm pretty happy with how this is coming, especially considering that we're in a very dark and creepy world, and yet this house is still relatively festive for the holidays. We will add some more windows over here, but with that, I think we are ready to go on the inside now. All right, so looking at the window situation, let's see what we can do here. We definitely need some more on this side, and it is possible we could also put a fireplace. The inside, though, definitely needs to be updated because this is super not in the style that is on the outside. It's way too modern, so let's get rid of all of these objects. Honestly, I don't really mind the stairs going right up the middle. I actually lived in a colonial house when I was young, so we had a very similar layout with the stairs immediately at the front door, just like this. And then maybe block it off just so that there is a little bit more privacy on each side. We could do, let's see, probably a nice wood for these stairs. I don't really have a color scheme in mind for the inside, but I do want something holiday themed. Could possibly go for something like this. I do like how it alternates between the white and the brown. I think that's a nice combination. I'm also thinking we can actually pull from the Vampire's Pack for the wallpaper, because there are some very nice tones we can use. So we do have something like this if we wanted to go green like this, which could be kind of fun. We certainly need to take care of this awful flooring situation because nothing is matching right now. Let me go ahead and use this. I also can use some of the parquet flooring that came with the pack. So I could do a nice entranceway like this. I do, however, need to open this up just a little bit, and we don't really have any good archways from this pack, but we could do an archway kind of like this just to open up the space. Probably gonna do more wall sconces. Vampires does not have any good wall sconces. We have these little candles, which are very gothic. Not very fitting for this home. I think I'm gonna play it safe and maybe do the base game swatch perhaps. I don't really mind the little bit of gold. I think it adds a nice touch, so let me do this. Probably we'll need another window back here just so we have a little bit more light. Honestly, I'm still not quite sure what this bump out is going to be. I just knew that I wanted more space in this house, especially if we had another bedroom up here. So hopefully we can figure something out for that area. Ooh, alternatively, this could be a really nice living room area. So we could have the maybe kitchen over here and have it be a little bit more elongated, if you will, and then maybe have a table here. If this is the living room area, I do want a fireplace, so let me get one of those. We do have one from the Vampires pack, which actually fits. All right, let's get a few of these wall sconces over just like so. We do also have the holiday celebration stuff, which can actually come very much in handy here. We do have this little garland piece, which could actually work. Ooh, this could be a fun option. Maybe some music here, that could be good. And maybe I can scale down the garland once more and just use it as an accent piece to the painting. So possibly something like this. I could also find a nice rug as well, which the Vampires pack fortunately does have. So let me do that. We do need some curtains, however, which are always kind of hard in this game. I always struggle with curtains for some reason. We do have these very fancy ones from the Vampires pack, but they're so small and unfortunately don't fit here. Ooh, could these work? Yes, I do like these a lot. It's been a long time since I've used these curtains. But base game is a friend here. Yes, it is. All right, let's give us a nice big archway just like this. And for the couches, we could also attempt the Vampires pack once more. All right, we do have this. And if I recolor it to a lighter palette, it almost works. Maybe it's a little bit too much. It's almost a little bit too ornate, Baroque, Gothic. I'm not really sure. We could do maybe something like this. This is not too bad. I do want to add a few more chairs over here. So let me get those that match. I could do these. These come in a slight green palette, which actually matches oddly enough. So let me do one of these here. Do we have room for a Christmas tree? I think we do if I squeeze it in a corner. I could put one here just like this. That's not too bad. Ooh, you know what? I think candles actually work better. So let me do this. I'll put some over here like so, and then maybe a few more on the fireplace as well. Maybe a sculpture in the middle, which I guess could be something a little bit more fancy. It is a little barren in this corner, but I'm not really sure what to do with it. I could possibly put another chair over there, maybe with a reading lamp. That could be a possibility. Definitely will pull from the Vampires pack now because I do really, really love those lamps. So let me grab one and place it over here just like this. And here it is, you guys. Here it is. I found the trellis, but it's too late. I already created one over here, but it's okay. I think we'll be fine. We do have these really nice objects here as well, which actually could work, even though this, of course, is not a dining room. I do like how this fits in here. We could also use a nice coffee table in the middle, and perhaps I could use just a little bit of music here as well. Aha, there we go, perfect. So let's do this and possibly put a gramophone and maybe some books. I think that will do the trick. All right, so just like this, I did a quick swap, and I think this is looking a little bit better now. I think all we need now are maybe a few pictures along the wall, maybe over here. I think I'll just go right for the base game and use some nice classic portraits. I think that should do the trick there. All right, I still wanted a bathroom down here, which I don't know if we have room for, unfortunately. I can shimmy this over just a little bit like this, and then possibly put in a small bathroom just like so. Ooh, we could even do a runner here, so let me borrow this from the Vampires pack. And then where is the option I'm looking for? Perfect. Probably gonna make this very strange area a closet of some kind. So let me close this off and I will bring in that wallpaper once more like this. All right, and for this bathroom, I will use the parquet flooring from the Vampires pack just to add a little bit more variety as well. All right, and for the bathroom stuff, I actually do want to use the vampire's toilet because it is very fancy and ornate. And if you do a gold swatch, it definitely fits with a more festive holiday theme. Do we have any vampire sinks? We do have this option, which actually works. Right, put it in just like that. And for the mirror, I think I will do something from base game. And probably this option will do the trick just like this. I almost forgot the toilet paper, which would have been disastrous, so let me go ahead and add that on in. Not really sure, honestly, of what to put in the closet, but I'll put one more light here, and then possibly just use a standing cabinet from the base game, I guess. All right, just like that, so it's kind of out of the way. Yeah, we don't really need our linens out. We can put it in the actual closet, so I think that's fine. Could put in some kind of column here with a flower on top. And I think that will tie the rooms together fairly well. All right, I think this is good enough for the bathroom. We're gonna move on to furnishing the hallway area, which is very sparse, but I think I'll add just a few chairs with an accent table here. Chairs might be a little bit hard to fit. I could put one maybe along this way. So I'll move this one over like this. All right, we're gonna go big. We're gonna go big with a mirror. We're gonna go vampires. So we have a nice grand mirror just like this. And I also can use more of these lovely holiday objects, but I think I will switch it up and maybe use the holiday log this time. All right, we could use these chairs once more, which are not too bad, but if I wanted to go a little bit slimmer, I could do something like this. On second thought, I'm not feeling the tapestry, so bye-bye. We will find another painting instead. I could also stack these two paintings, which I usually enjoy, or you know what, maybe just one is fine. Maybe something like this. All right, moving on over here, this will be the kitchen area. So this area is going to be really tricky. It is very narrow, but I'm going to see what we can do with it. I'm thinking we could actually have another bay window moment. I think that would be really nice for the kitchen area. I will also bring back some of the parquet flooring just like so. And I think just about here should be good enough for the kitchen, hopefully. Now I will say this pack has some lovely things for the kitchen. We do have some counters which are green, which could work. Yeah, I think these could actually work. So let's do this. Let's do this wonderful green option from the Vampires pack. Very traditional, very classical, but still very holiday oriented, which is absolutely perfect. I imagine the fridge is probably going to go in this space. So let me grab that really quickly. All right, some of these fridges are a little bit weird looking. They don't really go with the theme. So maybe, just maybe, we can go very classic and use this option and just carefully nudge it into place just like this. That actually blends in with the flooring as well, which I don't really mind. And it will pair with my favorite sink, which is this one. I think it breaks down quite a bit, but I do like the way it looks. And then finally, the stove can probably go along this space. I will also try and possibly add some cabinets above, just so we have some nice clutter on the wall there as well. All right, scoochie scoochie in place. It didn't really lock down perfectly, but I can move this over like this and just carefully align them together. And I think that just about does the trick there. Curtains are not going to be my friend here because we can't use the same exact options we used in the living room, but hopefully we can find something that works here. All right, call me crazy, but I think we can actually use this curtain. I've never used it before, at least not to my knowledge, but it does look fairly festive, and then I can actually use the smaller variations on these windows. So I think this will actually do the trick, so let me do this. All right, let me actually wall off the kitchen. I think everything will sit better against the wall, and the dining room will have just a little bit more privacy as well. Gonna grab this archway, but I will go for the smaller, narrower option. Just like this. Ooh, we are missing a trash can here. We're missing a trash can. So I can actually delete this and put a trash can next to the oven itself. I will also put in some very festive aprons along the wall as well. Right, very carefully there. And do we have good swatches to use? Possibly. We could go very festive with a Christmas theme. So that could be a possibility. All right, for kitchen clutter, let's see what we do have in base game. I do want to add some utensils, perhaps. I do love these boxes for some reason, so let me put them up here. They add kind of a rustic charm to the build. Do we need a corner piece here? I think we can actually resolve this a little better, so let me remove this. Copy one over here, and then just move the oven over. So the cabinets are not really going to be accessible, but I think this is a little bit more fitting for the room. All right, we are on to the dining room now, and we don't need this anymore. I can actually pull these from the other room. I'll borrow these from the bathroom and put these in here just like this. And I think we may be able to fit in a 4-seater at least, so let me see what we have for options. All right, if we are doing just base game and vampires, we do have this very small table, which could actually work in this small space. We're going to have a bountiful harvest. So possibly fruit, that could do the trick. Gonna put one bowl of fruit over here, scale it down just a little bit, and maybe a nice cake. I think that could be really nice. Do we have skinny chairs? I don't think we do, because we definitely need room to get in and out of this small room. So if we did that, we can put maybe a wall sconce over here like this, have the painting beneath it maybe. Ooh, you know what? These paintings may actually not be too bad in here. Just a little bit of spookiness in there. It's not gonna hurt anyone. It's a little homage to the world, so that's not too bad. So maybe the tapestry could go here. And then I can move the paintings back over here just like this. We may not even need that column, so I'm probably going to delete it if I'm being honest with you guys. So we'll have this here. Better yet, could I put some garland on the archway? I think that could be a really nice touch because I don't want to go too crazy on the space. So maybe something like this, that could be a really nice accent. And then one more over here as well. I think maybe just one flower over here or a small hutch. A hutch could be really, really nice. Could do this from base game just like that. And hopefully your Sims can get through. Maybe I need to scale this down just a little bit. And then maybe just one more flower. Maybe one more flower or a chair here. I don't know if that could do the trick. I know some dining rooms have extra chairs on the side, so that could be a thing. I might just put one just like this in the corner like so. All right, so I think we are all set with the bottom floor now. We do have the second floor next, but unfortunately, we don't really have a lot of space for a second bedroom. So I think we can still furnish just one, and hopefully that should be sufficient. The other thing I could do is create a small bathroom over here that both units can use. So that would allow us the little children's room that I originally planned. So let's do it like this. I'm gonna bring up the same wallpapers once more. Gonna use some more of this wonderful Vampire's Pack wood like this. And then possibly the parquet once more, just in the little bathroom area. All right, window placement. We do have some over here, and I can also mirror them towards this area as well. If I do something like this, perhaps. Bathroom is gonna be fairly simple because we just really don't have much space to work with. So I think we could do possibly a shower, a sink, and a toilet. So again, super, super simple. At this rate, the bathroom downstairs is probably more luxurious because it also has a linen closet. But you know what? We do have to work with the space we have. So I think this will have to do. I can try to fit in the whole shower from the Vampire's Pack, which could fit very well if I do something like this. And I think your Sims can get in. Please feel free to correct me if I'm wrong. But let's use this option like this. Now there will be quite a bit of people sharing this bathroom, so let me add a few towels like this. Toothbrushes should also be up here, so let me see if I can fit it. All right, can I fit the toothbrush on the sink? Yes, perfect. All right, and then possibly just a basic soap dispenser, and I think we should be pretty good with the essentials here. All right, the main bedroom definitely needs some love here. It's very long, which is quite odd, so I'm not really sure how I'm going to handle this. I could move the bed potentially over here like this and have it in this area, but we're gonna block off the door, so I don't think that makes a lot of sense. If we do the bed, we could go with the Vampire's Pack once more, and I think it'll still fit the look. I know that there is a lighter gold swatch. So let's do this. I will do a base game nightstand just like so. So your Sims are gonna have to do a little bit of shimmying, but I think it'll be okay. Definitely we'll need some wall sconces because it is super, super dark in this space. All right, it's not scaling right. I could use a different rug then. Add some variety. I'm gonna use a different rug this time. I will use a base game rug like this. And then maybe an ottoman in front of the bed. I think that will tie the space together nicely. All right, the bed is nestled. We do need some curtains, however. And I think that will also help with some of the space along the wall as well because it is very barren right now. So let's add a few of these curtains in just like this. And then maybe I can put in some sconces in between them as well. Ooh, I think that actually fits pretty nicely in there. Feels very royal in this build, which I honestly don't mind. We're probably losing a little bit of holiday flavor, but I think I will be okay with that. Ooh, better yet, let me do a fireplace. Let me do that. And I think that could work better than the dresser I had. And it will also warm the room, so there's an extra benefit. Let's bring in one of these colorful logs just to brighten up the space, and I'll put it in just like this, perhaps. and then possibly add another sculpture on top. We really need more books in here because there's just not a lot to do in this house in terms of activities, but I think that will do. I'll also put in the lovely ornate mirror from the Vampire's Pack. Let's try for a circular rug, perhaps. I don't really know if I can match the one below the bed, but if not, I can just kind of turn it into more of a cream tone. It's kind of matchy-matchy, but I gotta do what I gotta do. All right, cream it is. It's the only thing that would match, so there we are. I will put in a smaller dresser over here as well, just going for the base game option like this. Definitely will stay cozy with two nice armchairs. Could go green with these once more. Will they fit? Maybe, maybe not. I could even do one kind of on an angle like this, and then maybe have a small end table with it as well. Ooh, better yet, let's do the standing lamp. I do think I had one over here in the living room, so let me grab that over here just like this. This will be a nice cozy reading nook by the fire, so there we go. I do want to add just a little bit more clutter, so let me see if we can fit in a mirror, possibly in this very, very tight space over here. And we can possibly fit in a coat rack as well, just in this little tiny corner that we have. All right, and lastly is the child's bedroom, which I have not designed one in so long, you guys. I think it's still going to be a fairly cozy space, and I do want to try and match the parents' bedroom ever so slightly, so possibly this option could do the trick. We do also have some really fun rugs as well. I'm not really sure how they're going to fit with the theme, but perhaps something could work. Maybe the rug from the infant update, maybe something like this. Ooh, I do like these tones quite a bit. They're not really holiday inspired per se, but I do like that they're very desaturated and they do blend with the room fairly well. Do we have a better bed to match? Because this is not quite cream. It's not quite there. So let me do base game and see what we have here. Ooh, I do think I like this better. It deviates from the style a little bit, but I actually don't mind it. And it actually blends with the rug just a little bit. So let's do this palette. I really do like these soft kind of pastel purples and lavenders going on. This room will probably have a slightly different aesthetic from the parents' room, but I do want a more traditional style nonetheless. So I'm just trying to find things that match just a bit more. Going to use my favorite lamp here. This is absolutely perfect. I think we can also do the same dresser because it is fairly narrow and it does fit fairly easily into other spaces. So let me place it just like so. Paintings are a bit tricky because I don't know if anything quite goes with this theme, but I will just have to do my best. I could do something maybe simple like this and just have a nice clean landscape. Definitely will go for this very cozy and comfy little teddy bear chair and just kind of carefully place it in the corner just like so. I think it could make for a really nice reading nook, so let me add in a few books from the infant update as well, and just put it along the wall like so. I don't really think this is accessible, but you know what? It's for the looks, you guys. It is for the looks. An activity table would be perfect as well, so let me fit it in over here, just like this. I do have one more object that I do want to use because I do want to pay homage to our vampire heritage. And it is, of course, this lovely, lovely plushie here. I will size it down just a little bit, but I think it'll nestle quite nicely here next to the little activity table. This might be a little weird, but I think I will use this tripod floor lamp just so that we have a little bit more lighting in this area. We do need our chimneys. I almost forgot. But I do need to place them roughly to where they are on the inside. So hopefully I can get those to match up. All right, solid red. Oh, perfect. This is the perfect chimney for this. Yes, it is. And I'll scale it down just a little bit so it's not too obtrusive. All right, guys, we are finally done with the holiday house renovation, and this is a full look at the lot. This is obviously a renovation from EA's original build in the world of Forgotten Hollow. But of course, we're making this themed for the holidays. I went for a very colonial look with a red brick, and of course, very solid on that whole red, green, and white color scheme. I will actually switch it over to the night view because I do enjoy this view quite a bit, and for some reason, it actually becomes cheerier at night, which is absolutely what I was going for. So going to the inside now, this was a complete overhaul of what was here originally. I got rid of all of the modern amenities, a lot of the modern furniture, and went for a very classic traditional look. Of course, this is only base game vampires and, you know, some holiday celebration stuff on the side, but here it is. This is a look at the living room. Very festive and cozy with the Christmas tree, lots of holiday celebration objects with the candles, with the garland as well, and we do have some books and a gramophone if you do want a little bit of a activity for your Sims to do here. Moving over here, we do have the first floor partial bathroom, and also the very, very tiny linen closet I added in as well. But of course, moving on out, we do have the grand hallway here, lots of decor and places to sit down, but other than that, it's fairly straightforward. We do cross the staircase area here into the very, very small dining room, which I do wish was bigger, but I do think it is very festive nonetheless. And then moving on, we do enter the little kitchen area here, which I honestly did enjoy. I did enjoy using a lot of the Vampire's Pack cabinets, if you will. We now move upstairs to the bedroom spaces, but of course we do have the full yet very small bathroom over here, fully furnished with all of the amenities, and then of course going into this very, very long master bedroom, which I do think turned out fairly decent. It was very hard to make this space work, but we do have another lovely fireplace there, a wardrobe, a mirror, and of course this very lavish painting and bed as well. So I think that does the trick there. But of course, we do have one final room, and that is the little children's room that was not originally in the build itself. But I do like this room a lot. It definitely deviates a little bit in terms of style. But of course, we do have to have that little bit of vampiric touch. So I do have this little guy in the corner here. Overall, I hope you guys enjoyed watching this challenge. I will say that it did take quite a lot of work improving upon EA's original build. But of course, just like always, you guys are welcome to let me know how I did. Do you like the end result? Do you think I could have done something better? Either way, please feel free to share your thoughts in the comments. With that said, I hope you guys have a wonderful holiday season, and I'll definitely catch you all in the next build challenge. And of course, just like always, this has been TownieSimBuilds, signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.